Hello and welcome, it's Martin from Yes, I'm a Designer. Let me show you a cool new feature in Adobe Illustrator CC 2019. So this feature is called Global Edit. If you are familiar with symbols, it's sort of like symbols, but it's much more intuitive and easier to work with. So whenever you have multiple instances of the same thing in your artwork, even if it's on multiple artboards, now you can very quickly and easily update all of those instances at once. So here's a quick and simple example. We have these little star shapes or details in the illustration. I zoom a little bit closer so you can see it better. I selected it with the direct selection tool because I know it's within groups, so it would be difficult to select it otherwise. But once I have it selected, in the properties panel, we have this Start Global Edit option. Now, before I click on it, I just wanted to show you that there is additional features here or preferences that you can access through the dropdown. And first of all, you can see that you can match the results by appearance or size. You can also select both of them, but you can also decide whether you want to select all instances throughout all your artboards or just the current artboard, or even filter based on the orientations of the artboards, which is quite cool. You can also set a range of artboards if you want, and you can also decide whether you want to include objects outside of artboards, meaning on the canvas. But for now, I'm just going to keep everything the way it is by default, and having that shape selected, I'm going to click on Start Global Edit. Now what happens is that Illustrator immediately finds all the instances of this shape in this artboard. And if I now make any changes to my shape, so for example, if I select one of these points and drag it out, notice how all the other ones update. And the coolest thing is that those other instances might have different colors on them, or different appearance, or different in size, as you can clearly see here. But they still can update because their outline, their silhouette, is matching. And Illustrator found them simply by just looking at their outline. So it's not a special group, it's not something that I saved as a symbol, as I mentioned earlier. It's just simply Illustrator working out the similarities between these objects. And then again, of course, I can do all kinds of different things, like rotating this shape. You can see it's going to update all the other ones. But let's see what happens if I change its color, because that's an attribute that's different on all the other instances. Because I am in global edit mode, once I select a color, it will actually be applied to all of the other instances. So I can override all the other star colors, as you can see, which obviously is not necessarily something that you want to do, but it's good to know that you can also access this feature very quickly and easily. Now, I can of course undo this last step and get back to the original colors. And if I want to get out of this editing mode, all I have to do is to click on Stop Global Edit. It's good that there is an indication that I have multiple items selected with those little rectangles, so it will keep me aware of what I'm doing. Once I click on Stop Global Edit, now they are completely independent elements, so they are not going to update all at once. So if you ever work with complex illustrations and you use the same elements multiple times, this feature will really save you a lot of time. And just another example very quickly, here's this tree. And we can see there's a couple of trees here, but once I click on Start Global Edit, we can immediately find all the shapes that came from this original tree here on the left. So again, even though they are different in size and color, Illustrator could still trace back the origin and find the same outline on these elements. And once again, this allows me to make changes to them very quickly. For example, if I want to go to Path and Simplify, and turn these outlines into straight lines, I can just choose straight lines, and we will see that it will update on this first, but then it will also update on all the other ones. Once again, when I'm ready, I would just click on Stop Global Edit. And that's all I wanted to show you in this video, but if you want to learn more about the new Creative Cloud 2019 features in Photoshop, Illustrator, and InDesign, make sure you check back on our channel. Thanks a lot for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one.